Frozen, Mature was right. This movie was a bored fest. Good afternoon, everyone. This is your good old neighbor, Nick Cake, and Frozen 2, No Time to Die fan to that's one here, and welcome to the amazing video, where we hope you enjoy my review on The Hobbit, and stay tuned for my The Hobbit 2 review tomorrow, so I'm gonna watch that movie tomorrow, so yeah, it's the weekend, so after I go out with my dad tomorrow, but we'll see, because I'll probably the eyes, and probably I won't get to him, maybe next weekend, so yeah, stay tuned. So hey guys, so today, doing a movie review / rant on the murder of the Orwell Express. I really wish this movie was really fun, but no, it was really bored fest. Came out of the year of 2017. But at least this movie is not the number one worst movie of 2017. That's go to 9/11. Honestly, one of the worst movies of 2017, and that movie disrespect to the 9/11. You bastard, why would you do that? Anyway, see guys, it's not based, the stories of this movie is the character go on the train, and they have the murder mystery, so who murdered Johnny Depp, or whose murder ever seen, so they have to solve the case, and that's really a part of this movie. This movie's like a 2017 bad version of Knives Out. Honestly, this is Knives Out done bad, so yeah, and that's really part of this movie. So hey guys, I have never heard about this movie when I was a teenager, because I saw some crappy movie in 2017. Oh man, let me get started. I saw an Emoji movie in theaters. That one of the worst movie experiences of 2017. I will tell you about my worst movie experience for that video. Stay tuned for that. Wink. And so hey guys, and I saw a trailer of this movie and I was like, I don't know about that, but this movie have the potential to be a great murder mystery movie, because I really enjoy the murder mystery movie, not the Cruise the new Cruise the movie. Honestly, one of the worst murder mystery movie. No, not the Cruise from DreamWorks. I'm talking about the Crew based on the board game. So, board game is a much better than an actual movie. I might do a rant of the movie tomorrow. Stay tuned for that. And so, hey guys, well, I was like, yeah, you know what, I'm not gonna watch it. So, doing To Death and Denial, that movie worked pretty interesting. I really wanna watch this movie, but I didn't know this movie is the sequel to The Death and Denial. So, I might watch this movie. So, today, after The Hobbit, after I get done eating, I just watch this movie on FXM, which stands for FX Movie. So, after I watch this movie, and oh boy. I agree with Mature and Frozen. This movie is a bore fest. And this movie is sadly my number 10 worst movie of 2017. Stay tuned for my top 10 worst movie of 2017. And stay tuned for my top 10 best movie of 2017. La La Land is a much better than this trash. So, yeah. Sorry about that, guys. It's just my Pop Fanboy saving no vacation. All right, back with saying. So, hey, guys. Well, honestly, I don't really hate this movie like Jaws is really on 9/11. So, it still has some positives. So, I'm just going to call for you folks in the positives. So, yeah. So, hey, guys. The first positive about the movie is the production design. I really love the production design. The production design looks beautiful, looks pretty, looks amazing. I really love the production design. So the other positive about the movie is how to read the train setting. I really love the train setting. The train setting remind me I'm gonna be in the train and I really wanna make a murder mystery. So you can check out my Instagram about my casting idea for a next murder mystery after The Death of Nile. So yeah. And we got some amazing casting choice, well, except that one character, the voice of Green Goblin. Gonna get to that in a minute. Honestly, one of the worst performances I have seen by him. But the best character of this entire movie, it had to be George Gad's character. I have never seen George Gad would be in a murder mystery. And you know him, he was the voice of Olaf of Frozen 2. And thank God he's in the serious movie too. Really hope George Gad would do more serious movie. And I know Frozen 2 is really a serious animated movie. I don't know one of the most serious anime movie, but Olaf was being white-hearted, so yeah. So yeah, but in a good way. Way better than Olaf of Frozen 1, so yeah. And the direction and the cinematography looks beautiful. I really love the cinematography of the film. And the Daisy characters, I really enjoy Daisy characters. She's really beautiful. And let me see. I just really need the Frozen positive. So yeah, and the camera looks pretty good. Honestly, it looked decent. It's not the best camera work ever, but at least it's but I think the camera work is look pretty decent. But oh boy, we're gonna get to the negative. First off, I think the story is a really boring. I don't know, one of the most boring story of 2017. I really hope this movie will be like Knife Out, but nope, this movie screwed up, and this movie was a bore fest. And the Murder Express, I'm very sorry, I was not entertaining for the Murder Express because I was so angry that kill off Johnny Depp character. Why would you kill Johnny Depp character, man? I'm very sorry, just give some spoilers so this movie deserves it. And the climax of the film is a pretty underwhelming climax, and the villain twist, honestly, I just don't give a crap. And the ending was really underwhelmed, just like I was underwhelmed that the Hobbit climax, because I was pretty underwhelmed about that. And let me see. And the one character I really do not like, it has to be that one character with the voice of Green Goblin from the Spider-Man movies. Yep, he's over here. Honestly, one of the worst characters of Italian movie, because he was so annoying and he was so bored fast. And Green Goblin from No Way Home is a much better character than this crap. So, yep, screw that character in the butt. And so, sorry guys, that's the only positive, but I just have a lot of negative, so I just give a lot of negative, so overall guys, Murder of the Orient Express is honestly one of my number 10 worst movie of 2017 with a boring story, really liking characters, and that one character really getting on my nerves, just like that character voiced by Green Goblin. The climax was pretty underwhelmed, Murder Expert was not entertaining, and I really do not like this movie, but if you like this movie, more power for you, but for me, not so much. I really hope Death and Anaya will be a much better than that, because reason why? Because we got Guy Goodale. Woo, Guy Goodale. And sorry guys, I am giving this movie a 4 out of 10, it's a really a bad movie. And sadly, this movie don't deserve a seal of naked garbage, because I am not going that far to give this movie seal of naked garbage. Well, even if it's a 4 out of 10, this is really a bad movie, but this movie don't deserve a seal of naked garbage. So yeah, but don't worry, this movie is my number 10 worst movie of 2017. So I'm not gonna say a good day so because it's getting old. So yeah, that was my movie review, flash rant on the Murder of Orient Express. Tell me what you thought of this movie on the comment section below, where else. But I'm very sorry this review went longer. Hey, it's what it is. I can do what I want. It's, just don't blame me. Just don't blame me. Blame my censoring, because I keep censoring every single day, which is really getting on my nerve. And so, hey guys, if you like this video, hit the subscribe button to the kitchen, to this family. In my next review, it's had to be The Hobbit 2. And my next win is going to be the Crew of the Movie, because it's based on the board game. So I will explain about that after I watch The Hobbit 2, and I'll do a review on The Hobbit 2. So stay tuned for that. Wink, wink. And so, hey guys, and stay tuned. Hopefully stay tuned for my 2022 The Return of Stacy end credit, because it's going to be the final movie out of the Decade Saga. So I know they copied and edited it for the other studio. Like, come on, I'm making a movie for Lord of the Rings and Avengers style. So yeah. So hey guys, subscribe, comment, share with his family. And you can request me any review, rant, reaction, top list, ten style, and etc. too. You can request me anything you want. Just don't request me any personal stuff. And so, you guys, I'll see you next time. So long. Peace, you too. I'll see you guys tomorrow.